Hello everyone, today I am going to explain you one practical that is static stress concentration factor calculation for a plate with a center hole subjected to axial loading in a tension using finite element analysis software. And for this experiment we are using ANSYS workbench module for the analysis software. First of all, we will see introduction regarding the stress concentration. Mathematical analysis and experiment measurement shows that in a loaded structural member, mere changes in the section distribution of a stress occur in which the peak stress reaches much larger magnitudes than does the average stress over the section. This increase in a peak stress near holes, grooves, notches, sharp corners, cracks and other changes in a section is called stress concentration. The section variation that causes the stress concentration is referred to as a stress reserve, and there are some methods to reduce this stress concentration known as designing to reduce stress concentration. I am going to explain here some of the methods to reduce the stress concentration, that is the guiding lines of a stress by means of a notch, so that as compared to shaft depth in section in diagram B, you can reduce the stress concentration. Second method, use of the smoother interface. So in diagram A, here shaft depth we can see, while after using the smooth interface you can avoid the stress concentration. Next, elevation of a stress concentration by the removal of material is one of the method to reduce the stress concentration. Again, next method is by using the proper weld joints. Suppose the weld joints are shown in as figure A, then it will cause stress concentration. So proper weld joints as shown in a figure B should be there to avoid the stress concentration. Moving towards our practical, our title of the experiment is static stress concentration factor calculation for a plate with a center hole subjected to axial loading in a tension using FEA software. So this one is the rectangular plate and having the center hole. What is happening here, as length and width is measurable dimension in this diagram, but the thickness of this plate is very small and there is a sudden change in the cross sectional area of this plate because hole is placed at the center and this plate is subjected to the axial tension of having particular load, and because of that tension and change in a sudden cross section at the center of this plate and thickness is also minimum, we can observe here the stress concentration at the center of the plate. So stress concentration factor for plate having center hole is calculated by the following graph. Here this graph is stress concentration factor versus the diameter to the width ratio, and for the measurement or if you want to calculate the stress, first you get to know the stress concentration factor, and for this you get to know the diameter to width ratio. Suppose particularly one plate is given and diameter of that plate is D and width of that plate is D, then calculate the diameter to width ratio, and according to that you have to observe the stress concentration factor for particularly that plate. So for this numerical or for this experiment, our question statement is, consider a thin plate having dimension B is equal to 1000 mm, D is equal to 500 mm, H is equal to 5 mm, and pressure applied on a both side of 1000 N. Calculate the stress concentration near hole having diameter 250 mm, which is at the center of the plate. So basically length of the plate is given, that is 1000, weight is given 500, thickness is given 5 mm, and hole is present at the center of the plate and diameter of that hole is 250 mm. In this experiment we are going to calculate the stress concentrated, that is how much stress is there at the center of the hole of that plate, by numerical method also and by using ANSYS workbench. So by using first method, that is the numerical method, we have to calculate the, or we have to know stress concentration factor, and for that here D2B ratio, that is length to width ratio, is calculated and it is 0.5. and for that, from the previous graph we get to know that the stress concentration factor for the particular plate is 2.15. next simple formula, that is the maximum stress or stress concentrated, how much amount of stress is concentrated, is calculated by using formula, that is sigma max is equal to Kc into sigma average, where Kc is the stress concentration factor and sigma average is the average stress. It is equal to P upon A. So area for that plate is B minus D into H, because we have to reduce that area of the hole, and by putting the all values we will get to know the maximum stress, amount of stress acting on that plate is 1.72 pascal. Now this is all about the numerical method, and we already get by numerical method stress acted on that plate due to the stress concentration is having the magnitude, that is 1.72 pascal. This one is the one method numerical, and now I am going to show you one analysis method, and for that I already said that is ANSYS workbench module is going to use. This one is the ANSYS workbench user interface. In that, left hand side toolbox is given, and from that I am going to select static structural, and it will appears on the project schematic window, that is a new project static structural. I am going to change here name stress concentration, you can give any name. General FEA procedure is having the 3 step, that is the pre-processor, processor and post-processor. So for the pre-processor we have to give the input data and engineering data, geometry, model, setup is the 4 step which includes in the pre-processor. Solution is the processing step, and results we can achieve from here, that is the post-processor. Now you can import already created geometry here in the geometric tab by using the right click, import geometry. Otherwise I am going to draw geometry in workbench itself. So I am going to double click on the geometry, and this ANSYS workbench, it will take you on new window, that is the design modeler. And for this design modeler I am going to here select XY plane. This one is the all your menus, you can here create file, you can use various tools, generate tab is there, extrude, revolve, sweep commands are there. This one is your current tree outline, here you can see where you are, and for this tree outline details you can give from this details view window, and this one is your graphics window. So I am selecting here XY plane, and from here I am going to draw one rectangle. So this one is your first step, draw rectangle. Next step, draw circle. Next step is giving the proper dimension. I am selecting here general dimension. If you are selecting here horizontal, then you can only give the horizontal dimensions. So general dimensions, horizontal h1, vertical v2, diameter, and this hole is at the center of the plate, so center distance. By selecting the center of the circle and any one of the side, and carefully change here from the menu bar, that is unit, from meter to millimeter, because our all dimensions for the geometry are in millimeter. Next, give the dimensions in details view. H1 is 1000 mm, V2 is 500 mm, D3 is diameter of the circle is 250. Center length is 500 by 2, and central height is 250, that is 500 by 2. So by giving all the dimensions here, one tool is there, that is zoom to fit, and clicking this tool here, and by rotate and panning all this and using the scroll up and down, I can see here geometry. Now geometry is created. Next step, give the thickness of 5 mm. For that, again go to the modeling section, and in that tree outline select your sketch. We have to give the thickness to this sketch, so select this sketch and click on extrude tab. Now in details view, add material. We have to add material, and depth is 5 mm. Enter. Next step is just click on generate. Again use zoom to fit window and pan and scroll up and down. You can easily see your geometry, and by rotating this geometry you can see here also thickness is added. This is all about the geometry creation or specimen creation. Otherwise you can import that file from other file, but one necessary action, that geometry, it should be in IGS file format for the importing in the ANSYS workbench. Now this is all about first step, close this window. Now next step is we have to give boundary conditions, and for that double click on the model, and this green recycle circle shows that it will going to update your upstream data, and it will again gives you the mechanical user interface window. By clicking on double clicking on model, it will again open stress concentration mechanical user interface, and our geometry is also imported here, that is the plate having the center hole. Next step is you can see here new window and outline and details of the models. Now in this outline you can see the steps. If you are clicking on a static structural, then one environment tab appear here. From here you can give the data regarding the loads, supports, condition, etc. And by clicking on the solution you can observe one tab, and it will shows you deformation, strain, stress, energy. But as input data is incomplete, so software shows the question marks in front of the static structural and solution. Now for input data, I am clicking here on the static structural. Next step is application of the load. Application of the load, select simple force, and this force is on the one side. So select face selector, that is the face, and select one side carefully, and it will shows the in a green color, and don't forget to click on the apply. Next, insert the magnitude, that is 1000 newton, and direction you can see here. Otherwise if you want to change the direction, then you can also change direction here by clicking on this, but it is outward, so apply. Next is apply the second boundary condition, that is the fixed support. So by reversing the plate on opposite side, by selecting the support, and in that fixed support again I am selecting the face, apply. Next I want in result total deformation and equivalent stress or maximum principal stress. Now it will shows the lightning symbol because the upstream data is not considered here. So for that consideration, just click on solution. You can right click on solution and you can say the solve. Otherwise click on solution, and here in upstream menu bar select solve. It will take 2 to 3 minutes for the solving the numerical, and it will shows you result. Now, for this numerical, I am not going to change here the meshing. In next step, I am going to show how the meshing is get affected. Here, by default, meshing is used by the software. Now, by clicking on a total deformation, you can see here the result. That is, this support, this side is fixed side. Fixed support is there and load is acting on this, so you can see animation. If 1000 newton force is applied at the one end of the plate, so total deformation here is 0.00285. That is the maximum, and it is in mm. Now, principal stress. Animation of the principal stress, and this one is the magnitude, that is 1.71 pascal. Now see here, you can see the max and mean probe, and by using max and mean probe, maximum stress concentration is at the inner side of the circle, and by numerical method we already calculated, that is, it is 1.72. so the answer and numerical answer is approximately same, so we can say that the answer is validated. Now, by default meshing is like this, and software is getting this by default mesh for the solving the problem. Now, for the in this you can see here there are abrupt change in a meshing elements, okay. There is a no predefined shape of that meshing, and for that predefined shape of that meshing and their cross sectional area changing, the shape of the area, shape of the element is going worst. So for that, insert the face meshing, map face meshing, and select all faces using the control button. So first face, using control button, so by using the control key, I am selecting here faces, all faces except the inner face of the circle. Remember that while selecting the face, use the control key. And click on apply. So here you can see 6 faces geometry are selected, and click on mesh and right click and click on generate mesh. So you can observe here the redefined mesh system. So as compared to previous automatic mesh, due to the map face meshing, there is a particular pattern, and even if there is a change in the cross section, only size of the element is changing here, and but the shape of the element will remain constant. And as we are going to change the mesh here, so again solution is gets updated. So again click on solution and again click on the solve. So by selecting the maximum principal stress. You can see here that is the 1.75, and this change in result is due to the mesh refinement, or you can say the map based meshing. But again, result or conclusion for this practical is stress by the numerical calculation is 1.72 and stress by the ANSYS calculation is 1.749, and hence it is approximately same, so results are validated. This is all about the practical. Thank you for the listening.